In this video, let us discuss about the different types of political clubs formed in France during the French Revolution. This is chapter number 1, the French Revolution of class 9th. So from time to time in French during the French Revolution, different types of political clubs were formed. We would be discussing about these political clubs. We would be discussing about who were the members of the club. We would be discussing about what were these clubs. We would be discussing about their leaders. We would be discussing how do they get their name. We would be discussing about who were the members and what has they done in order to distinguish themselves from the other members of the society. And we would be discussing about how were these clubs they were successful during the French Revolution. Now to start with, we would be starting with the definition of a political club. What is a political club? Political club can be defined as the groups which are formed by the like-minded people who meet socially outside the legislature. First of all, political clubs are outside the legislature. It is not within the house. Here legislature can be the, in our example for the case of India, it can be the parliament, it can be the legislative assembly. Okay, so all those clubs, all those groups which are formed by like-minded people means people having similar thinking. These are like-minded people. So these are formed by like-minded people and they are formed socially. That is not because of any law. It is because they are formed socially so that the desired objectives can be achieved. So what were the political clubs? Why were the political clubs formed? What are the reasons of forming these political clubs? Political clubs were formed by the people in France to discuss the policies of the government, which gave the political rights only to the rich sections of the society and to plan their actions. So what is the reasons of forming the political club? The reason of forming the political club is that people, they wanted to discuss about the policies of the government. Those policies which gave rights only to the rich sections of the society, and they wanted to plan their activities as well. So the reasons behind forming the political club was that they wanted to discuss about the policies. Who formed them? Who were the people that formed the political clubs? Now, it was both men and women, they formed the political clubs. So both sections, that is from the males also and the females also. Both males and females, they formed the political clubs. The next part is, which were the most famous political clubs formed? From time to time, large number of political clubs were formed. But the most important that was formed was, first from the women, it was the Society of Revolutionary and Republican Women. The most famous club formed by the women was the Society of Revolutionary and Republican Women. And the men's who formed this club was the Friends of Freedom and Equality, is the name of the political club, which was the most important, most famous political club in France. The most famous political club in France was named as Friends of Freedom and Equality. This club was most popularly known as Jacobin clubs, or simply it was called Jacobins. So whatever clubs were formed in France, a large number of clubs were formed in France, both by the males and the female. But the most famous among the club that was formed in France was known as the Friends of Freedom and Equality. This was most commonly known as the Jacobin club, or it was simply known as Jacobins. Now the question arises, who were the members of the Jacobin clubs? The member of the Jacobin club were from the less prosperous sections of the French society. They were not rich. They were the less prosperous section of the French society. For example, they were small shopkeepers, artisans, shoemakers, pastry cooks, watchmakers, servants, etc. So this category was from the less prosperous section of the society. They were the members. How did the Jacobin Club got its name? Why do we call the club Friends of Freedom and Equality as a Jacobin Club? It got its name from the former convent of Saint Jacob in Paris. So the club was named after Saint Jacob in Paris. So it was called the Jacobin Club. Who was the leader of the Jacobin Club? The leader was Maximilien Robespierre. Maximilien Robespierre was the leader of the Jacobin Club. How did the members of the Jacobin Club distinguish themselves from the fashionable society of France? They wanted to look different from other people in France. So what had they done in order to be different from the fashionable society of France? Now what has they done? A large group of Jacobins, they started wearing long striped trousers. Remember the trousers. These are the long striped trousers similar to those which was worn by dock workers. Dock workers, they used to wear such type of trousers. It is a long striped trousers worn as worn by the dock workers. The large group of Jacobins, they started wearing such uniform. This was to set themselves apart from the fashionable sections of the society, especially the nobles. The nobles were the fashionable section of the society, and the Jacobins, they selected a uniform that was having a long striped trouser, and they wanted to distinguish themselves from the fashionable sections of the society, especially the nobles. And nobles, they wore knee breeches. The type of dress worn by the nobles were called knee breeches. And in order to distinguish themselves, in order to be apart from the fashionable sections of the society, they started wearing knee breeches. They started wearing trousers. What type of trousers? Long striped trousers they started wearing. And these Jacobins, they came to be known as sand clutches. The Jacobins, they came to be known as sand clutches, which means those without knee breeches. So knee breeches are worn by the nobles, the fashionable sections of the society. They wanted to be different from them. So the Jacobins, the members of the Jacobins, they started wearing long striped trousers. And long striped trousers. So Jacobins members also were known as sand clutches. It means those without knee breeches. Sand clutches wore in addition to red cap. And this red cap symbolizes liberty. So sand clutches men, they wore in addition to this long striped trousers, along with the long striped trousers, they started wearing red cap. And this red cap symbolizes liberty. However, women were not allowed to do that. Women, they were not allowed to wear this red cap. Okay, what was the name given to the newly elected assembly of Jacobins? The Jacobins, they formed an assembly. And the name of the assembly that was formed was Convention. Convention was the name of the assembly which was formed by the Jacobins. So how we can define Convention? We can define Convention as the newly elected assembly formed by the Jacobins. The newly elected assembly formed by the Jacobins is called Convention. What was the contribution of the Convention? It abolished monarchy. Convention abolished monarchy and declared a republic. Means the monarchy was abolished and republic was declared. What is meant by republic? Republic is a form of government where people elect the government, including the head of the government. Republic is a type of government where people elects the government, including the head of the government. It means in republic there is no hereditary ruler or a monarch. So this topic that you have done on Jacobins or the political clubs is the most important topic for 1 marks question or for small answers, for short answers. So we are expected to read this topic very closely, and we are also expected to learn these short questions which can be asked during the examination.